Hello everyone, good evening, welcome to the session guys. Our today's session is going to be a very, very, very holistic, advanced practice exercise on vocabulary and grammar. So welcome to the session everyone, I hope you're all doing well. आज के session में हम लोग करेंगे practice vocabulary और grammar की and not just, you know, synonym, antonym questions guys. We're going to look at a variety of questions which are very relevant from all your examinations, you know, whether any OMET examination you take it for that matter, whether it's that exam, IFT ho, ZAT ho, CMAT ho, CET ho, SNAP ho, NMAT ho, guys, sare exam ke perspective se, jitne bhi different types ke questions aate hain, aaj hum log wo dekhne wale. So I hope you're all ready guys, vocabulary and grammar, advanced level practice exercise on your screen. So once again everyone, welcome to the... Right guys, so let's get started with our session, vocabulary and grammar, advanced practice exercise. So guys, aaj ke question, hello Jasraj, welcome to the session. Hi Rishi, how are you doing? So guys, once again, welcome to the session, let's get started. So guys, let me remind all of you that those who have not yet subscribed to the channel, guys, subscribe immediately. Unacademy, Catfir MBA, your the complete support guys. Chahe wo LR ho, DI ho, VA ho, RC ho, chahe wo GK ho, chahe wo strategy sessions ho, chahe wo live sessions ho, chahe wo mentorship sessions ho, your entire practice happens here. So all of you, subscribe to the channel Unacademy, Catfir MBA. Guys, for your entire VRC preparation, I want you to join the VRC preparation group, Unacademy underscore Ritu Dudhoria, Telegram pay, link is in the description below guys, just click on it. So, special classes, it is very important for us to attend the live special classes guys, ye free live special classes hai, jo aapko Unacademy app pe milti hai, so I want all of you to download the Unacademy learning app. Immediately unlock the free plan guys, unlock the free plan using the code RITUMBA. Now once you unlock the free plan using RITUMBA, you can use this code in order to view any special class, not just my special class, but any special class. Aap ye code use kar sakte ho to give any test, chahe wo SNAP ke previous papers ho, chahe wo ZAT ke previous papers ho, chahe wo TISNET ke ka test series ho guys, any previous paper, any quiz, any other free product, you can just unlock the free plan using the code RITUMBA. Okay guys, so I want you to remember this and I will see you on our special classes guys, 6 PM daily. So aaj bhi guys, is session ke baad, humara special class hai, so I want all of you to quickly join in. Every day, 6 PM free live special classes for all of you. Unlock using the code RITUMBA and guys, I want to see everybody taking the plus subscription as well. So your code guys, your holistic code, chahe wo free plan unlock karne ke liye hai, chahe wo plus subscription lene ke liye hai, your code is RITUMBA. So I want all of you to apply the code and avail the 10% discount guys. So these are the prizes before applying the code and these are the prizes after applying the code. Are yes, yes Ambresh. So I think, so aaj, let us see. Okay, so welcome guys. Yes, so aaj kyunki guys, it's been 5 years since Unacademy, you know, Unacademy ke 5 saal ho gaye hain. So that is why guys, aaj, because of the event, uske kaaran, only today I have preponed humare class thode se advanced kar diye gaye hain. So today I'm going to meet you at 5 PM. Every day I'm going to meet you at 8 PM. Okay guys, I want all of you to use the code RITUMBA and take the subscription. Guys, apply the code with best educators, best content, best practice exercise, best tests, best mentorship, best guidance and complete and holistic preparation. And for all of this, you have to just apply the code RITUMBA. Hi Diya, I'm doing good. Hamrish, 5 years. Yes, Diya, I'm good. I hope you're all doing good too. Correct, guys. So I want everybody to apply the code RITUMBA. Done, guys? Come on, let's get started. So guys, ACE Vocabulary and Grammar, the advanced practice course, the plus course is already launched. Aap log sab enroll karo, classes full swing mein hai, guys. Every weekend, I meet you 9:30 PM onwards. So guys, vocabulary and grammar, no stone left unturned guys, CAT 2021 ho, chahe ZAT 2021 ho, IFT 2021 ho, SNAP 2020 ho, NMAT ho, no stone is going to be left unturned, okay? Yes, correct Diya. अरे थैंक यू सो मच जसराजन. यस जसराज, ग्लैड दे आर हेल्पिंग यू. सो यस गाइस, एवरीबडी, इट गोज आउट टू ऑल ऑफ यू. मोस्ट ऑफ यू आर फेसिंग, यू नो, इफ यू हैव प्रॉब्लम्स इन ग्रामर एंड वोकैबुलरी, गाइस आई सजेस्टेड ऑल ऑफ यू दिस कि इसी चैनल के प्लेलिस्ट में है वोकैबुलरी मेड इजी के 8 वीडियोस और ग्रामर मेड इजी के 8 वीडियोस. सो जस्ट वॉच दोस 8 and 8 वीडियोस गाइस. योर वोकैबुलरी वोज विल बी सॉर्टेड, योर ग्रामर वोज विल बी सॉर्टेड. दिस इज माई गारंटी. So I want all of you to check out the playlist, guys. The important session links have been posted on the VRC prep group as well. Unacademy underscore Ritu Dudhodia. Why Diya? Kyu kya hua? Okay. So guys, shall we begin with the session? Yes or no? Shall we start, guys? Come on. Let us start with today's session. So guys, lots of a volley of questions are going to come your way. 20, you know, guys, देखते हैं कितने आंसर कर सकते हैं हम लोग. ऑल डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ क्वेश्चंस गाइस, ऑल डिफरेंट पैटर्न्स ऑफ क्वेश्चंस, चाहे वो एनालॉजी हो, चाहे वो फिल इन द ब्लैंक्स हो, चाहे वो मैच द फॉलोइंग हो, चाहे वो ग्रामर हो, चाहे वो क्रॉसवर्ड्स हो, चाहे वो जम्बल्ड वर्ड्स हो, चाहे वो अनजम्बल्ड वर्ड्स हो, सबके सब गाइस का हम लोग रिविजन करेंगे. एवरी थिंग वी आर गोइंग टू रिवाइज. डन डन गाइस. हाँ यस दिया. सो यस गाइस, सो आई वॉन्ट यू टू सिलेक्ट अनअकैडमी एज योर preferred platform and the only platform for your entire exam preparation. Okay guys, come on, let's get started. Exactly, Jaswant, aapko a very good Jaswant. That's really great that you know so much. Hello Hemant, welcome to the session. So guys, how is everyone doing today? Right, great. So guys, everybody has joined in. Come on, shall we get started guys? Let's get started. Chalo guys, the first question is on your screen. You have to unjumble the word and choose its synonyms. Guys, aise questions humne pichle session mein bhi kiye the. These questions, you know, these avant-garde questions, ye IFT mein bahut puche jaate hain. Arey guys, aap sab log kya mujhe app pe dhoond rahe ho? One minute, guys. I know, usually I meet you at 8 p.m. But kyunki aaj, you know, there is a special event planned. So that is why I'm going to meet you only today. I'm meeting you all at 5 p.m. Okay, dekhte hain guys. Aap sab log mujhe Unacademy pe dhoond rahe ho. Okay, yes, correct Ravi. You remember this question? Very good. Correct guys. So let's get started with this. So loquacious. Now when I say loquacious guys, what do you mean by loquacious? Yes, Amresh. So what is loquacious guys? Haan, Raj. Aaj wo special class mein hai. Yes, Raj. Guys, जैसे जैसे लिंक्स है बस उसको फॉलो करो, आप करेक्ट करेक्ट प्लेटफॉर्म्स पे पहुंच जाओगे. यस गाइस, सो कम ऑन गाइस, लोक्वेशियस फॉर एजुकेटर्स. सो लोक्वेशियस का मतलब क्या होता है गाइस? लोक्वेशियस इज बेसिकली समवन हु इज वेरी टॉकेटिव और समवन हु इज वेरी वर्बोस. करेक्ट, द आंसर ऑप्शन इज ए. क्विकली गाइस, इट कैन नॉट बी टैसिटर्न. टैसिटर्न मीन्स साइलेंट. अ रैशनल पर्सन इज अ वेरी वाइज पर्सन. Alluring, for example, you know, you're allured by the guys. आप एक stone देखते हो and the stone is shining and sparkling and the let's say I say the stone is resplendent. What do you mean by resplendent? Resplendent means very bright and colorful. So it is alluring you. Allure करना मतलब it is attracting you. It is captivating you. So alluring, attracting. So that is called allure. Yes guys, so when you say loquacious, loquacious is talkative or verbose. Answer option is A. Come on guys, next one. Isko unjumble karke synonym dhundo. Come on guys, innocent, gruesome, pleasing, tarried. Chalo dekhte hain who gets the right answer guys. Come on guys. Haan diya, done. Okay, so guys, unjumble the word and choose its synonym. Innocent, tarried, gruesome, pleasing. Unjumble guys, come on. Come on everyone. Innocent hoga to, see guys, you can also play from the options. If it's innocent, it will be something like naive. Okay, it's going to be something like ingenuous. Yahan pe naive nahi dikh raha hai, yahan pe ingenuous nahi dikh raha hai. If it is, let's say, tarried. Tarried basically means to delay. Okay, delay karna, talna, that is called tarried. So that will have something to do with delay. Okay, so guys, dekh ke batao. Gruesome, what is gruesome? Something which is very terrible. Okay, something which involves a lot of death, gore, bloodshed. So what is your answer? What is your answer, guys? Come on, everyone. What is the answer? Guys, अभी तक nobody is answering. क्या हो गया? Innocent, tarried. Okay, I'll help you with this, guys. चलो, I will unjumble the word at least for you, but you have to tell me the answer. Okay, what do you mean by massacre, guys? When you say, come on, when you say it is a very gory, when you say bloodshed, when you say massacre, what is your answer option? Your answer option is C. Word is massacre and the answer option is gruesome. Something which is very terrible, something which involves a lot of bloodshed, something which is very gory. So, M-A-C, guys, ye aapne kaise unjumble kar liya? Because you know, theek hai, loquacious, you've heard of the word, so you were able to unjumble it. So, if you know the word, you will be able to unjumble it. So, iske liye, guys, when we did massacre, as synonym for massacre, humne ye word kiya tha. Massacre, carnage, bloodshed, mass killing, genocide, you know, then we had done this word. So you can say massacre, you can say carnage, you can say genocide. All of this means mass killing or something which is very terrible, right? Come on, guys. Next one. Let's see who gets this. This is a little bit difficult, guys. Chalo, dekhte hai who gets this. These are all PYQs, guys. IFT ka PYQ hai ye. This is a previous year question of IFT. Come on, guys. Let's see who's going to get the answer to this. Come on, everyone. Come on, Himanshi. Come on, Dia. Come on, guys. Come on, Ravi. Come on, Jaswant. Chalo, Amresh. Come on, Rishi, Jasraj. Come on, guys. I'll give you a synonym for this. Theek hai, I'll give you a synonym for this, guys. Nitpick. Guys, what do you mean by nitpick? Nitpicking karna matlab kya hota hai? If you say you keep nitpicking about, nitpicking matlab kya hota hai? Come on, what is nitpicking? The word basically is, nitpicking. What is nitpicking? What is pernickety behavior? Nitpicking kya hota hai, guys? Are you spiteful? You have a lot of hatred? You have a lot of enmity? Are you careless? Are you ignorant? Or are you fussy? If you're a nitpicker, aap chote chote baat pe pick, you know, you keep picking on people, you keep finding faults, you're very, very fussy, you're very, very difficult to please. Aap har chote chote baat mein nooks nikalte rehte ho. Nooks nikalna. Which option means nooks nikalna? Correct. Your answer option is D. Your answer option is D, fussy. Correct. Yes, Dia. Cataclysm for which one? For which one, Dia? Cataclysm for which one? Acha, for the genocide one, yes, of course. Cataclysm is a wide scale. Not focus carefully, Ravi. Focus carefully, positive ho gaya. Ye aap focus karke nooks nikalte ho. So this becomes a little negative. Yes, Dia. Dia, cataclysm is, of course, for massacre, for carnage, of course. Of course. Very good. Come on, guys. Analogy. You have to, all of these are PYQs, guys. Whatever questions are going to come your way today are all previous year questions. Now, analogy is basically a relationship. Now, Cicerone is a guide. Okay, Cicerone is a guide. Who's a dragoman? Come on, guys. Cicerone is a guide. He's an escort or he's a guide. Jo aapko place dikhata hai, jo aapko, you know, who guides you. When we go to, let's say, tourist places, etc. also, wo guide bhi ho sakta. It could also be someone who's an escort who shows you around the, let's say, company, office, etc. Now, guys, you tell me what is the answer for this option. This is an eponym. It is named after someone. Jaise humne kiya tha Procrustes, humne kiya tha Achilles, humne kiya tha Titan, humne kiya tha Hercules, humne kiya tha Maudlin. Waise, who was Dragoman? Come on, guys. Turkish, Arabic, Persian speaking country se iska root word origin hai. So, Dragoman, see guys, aap log dekh sakte ho ki kitna, very good. The answer option is interpreter. So, he was a translator or he was an interpreter. Very good. Wonderful, guys. Next one. Sylvan. When you say Sylvan Bliss, guys, Sylvan is related to the forest. Sylvan is related to woods. Now, when you say woods, guys, woods basically means forest. What is terrestrial related to? Without a doubt, guys, all of you should get this right. I want to hear, you know, I want to hear myself saying 100% accuracy. Is question me? You can easily get 100% accuracy. Sylvan is associated with woods. Terrestrial is associated with? Terrestrial is associated with? Come on, Ravi. Come on, Vishal. Come on, Roma. Terrestrial is associated with earth. Correct? Earth. Because terrestrial matlab related to land or related to earth. Good. Very good. Urban means city, fear, earth and planets. Wonderful. Very good, Sahaja. Very good, Rakshita. Come on, guys. Fill in the blanks. You have two blanks and you have two words. Hello, Sakshi. Welcome to the session. Guys, Sakshi, where are my emojis? Hello, Sakshi. Despite being the dash partner in the relationship, why not urban? Because urban is associated only with city. Urban is associated only with city. But terrestrial is associated with land. It can be city, it can be rural, it can be forest, it can be anything. So when you say an extraterrestrial, okay, it's not. When you say ET, guys, ET kya hai? Extraterrestrial. So when you say extraterrestrial means belonging to another planet, an alien outside Earth. So terrestrial is Earth, extraterrestrial becomes an alien. Guys, have you watched the movie ET? Have you watched the movie ET, guys? Ha, Shashank, definitely will launch one and I will keep you updated on it. Okay. Abhi, Shashank, daily we are doing special classes mein decision making. So I want you to join those as well. Agar Sylvan nahi pata hota, toh tab ab kya karoge? So tab, Himanshi, you will play with the options. You will play with the options. Look at this. It's terrestrial. Ya toh synonymous hoga, ya toh antonymous hoga. So, urban is not the antonym of terrestrial. Planet is not the antonym. Fear is not the antonym. So it has to be a synonymous relationship because you know terrestrial and you know the meaning of the options, you would still be able to figure it out, Himanshi. Okay, guys, you've not watched ET. Array, have you seen the movie Koi Mil Gaya? Have you seen the movie Koi Mil Gaya, guys? Jadoo. So ET was a ET is a similar movie. Bahut achhi movie hai, guys. When you get a chance, do watch it. It's a very endearing movie. It will definitely bring tears to your eyes at the end of it. Okay, come on, guys. Six questions, sort of. Yes. Ha, okay. Ha, Jaswant, I wouldn't recommend. Just koi nahi dekha. Jaswant, I must say, ha, hamare movie ke choices itne similar hai. Yes, Ravi, ET is a Hollywood film. Okay, come on, guys. Despite being the dash partner in the relationship, the franchisor does not always have all the dash. Despite being the dash partner in the relationship, the franchisor, you're talking about a franchisor. So when you take a franchise of a, let's say company, agar aap koi bhi company ke franchisor bante ho, unka store kholte ho, unka ek branch kholte ho, so what is it? Now, guys, you have to focus on this word, despite. So when you use despite, it's going to show a contradiction. It is going to show a contradiction. Aap ho, fir bhi aapko nahi mil raha hai. So you have to show or you have to bring about a contradiction there. Now, despite being the sincere partner in the relationship, the franchisor does not always have all the limitations incorrect. Okay, authoritative partner, definitely a franchisor is not an authoritative partner. He is an active partner or he is a dominant partner. So ya to dominant ho sakta hai ya to active ho sakta hai. Okay, now he does not always have, does not, not is already negative. Yahan pe aapne positive word dal diya. Here we needed a negative meaning, not is already negative. So here we'll put a positive word. Yes or no, guys? Hum log yahan pe positive word dalenge? Yes, correct. The answer option is C. He does not have all the advantages. If you say he does not have all the losses, that is good. No. How will you use the word despite there? And you cannot say have the losses. You don't have the losses. You incur losses. See the words also which have been used. You either incur losses or you bear losses. Correct. The answer option is C. Come on. Seventh question. Seventh question, guys. With large classes, it is difficult for teachers to dash regular essay type questions for homework because dash lone answers would take too much time. Understand the sentence, guys. Understand the question. You're saying regular essay type questions, large classes may. Because lone answers, single answers, individual answers, every single person's answers would take too much time. Focus, Ravi, teacher ke perspective se focus karo. How, A, guys, is the teacher writing lone answers? It is difficult for teachers to consider regular essay type questions for homework because writing lone answers would take too much time. Why would writing lone answers would take too much time? Every child is going to write the answer in their house and come. No. Writing mein problem nahi hoga. Correction mein problem hoga. Evaluation mein problem hoga. Guys, you tell me. Suppose we are having a VAT class. Theek hai? So is it difficult for you to write the essay and come at home, or it will be difficult for me to evaluate your essays in class? If there are 25, 60, 100 people, it'll be 100 people. It is difficult for the students to write it? No, everybody is going to write their own essay and come. It is not difficult to write the essay. It'll be difficult for the teacher to evaluate the essay. So writing is out of question here. Ye option chala jayega. B goes out. Feeling, you don't feel answers. C goes out. So what is it? For handle regular essay type questions for homework, weighing lone answers. Weighing over here means basically evaluating. Weighing over here basically means assessing. So isliye you will go with the answer option weighing. So A or D ke beech mein doubt tha, guys. It cannot be writing because you're looking from the teacher's perspective. So answer would be weighing. Did all of you understand this? Clear, guys? Come on, next question. Patriotism is the last refuge of scoundrel, says Johnson. In the modern world where the cunning, selfish people, a scoundrel, dash, and the hardworking, conscientious people, someone who are hardworking, someone who are scrupulous, people who are moral, the quotation holds good. Focus on this. You have cunning, selfish people, and you have hardworking and moral people. Come on. Come on, guys. It's the last refuge of the scoundrel. Let's see who gives the right answer. Patriotism is the last refuge of scoundrel. Ye thoda sa negative quotation hai. So where the cunning, selfish people dominate and the hardworking, conscientious people suppress. You can't say suppress. You will have to say are suppressed. So answer option cannot be A. Roma, you can say selfish people dominate, but the hardworking people are suppressed. Otherwise, dominate and suppress both are synonymous. Dominate karna kisi ko, suppress karna kisi ko. So the selfish people thrive, wo achha karte hain, but the moral people suffer. Correct. This is a contradiction which is coming across. Enjoy. Mutilate means kill, destroy, mar, spoil. Irrelevant. Selfish people empower. Empower what? People subjected. Subjected to what? So what is your answer option? Your answer option will be B. Your answer option is B. Very good, guys. Clear, everyone? You have to see. Aapko word fit karke dekhna padega. If you say hardworking people subjected. Subjected to what? If you say cunning selfish people empower. Empower whom? Empower what? Okay, so answer option will be B. Hello Azad, welcome to the session. Guys, ye dikhte kaun karta hai? These are all eponyms. Theek hai? These are eponyms. I'm sure you all remember Adonis. Who is an Adonis, guys? We have done a complete session on eponyms. Who is an Adonis? Now, when I asked you, aap mein se kaun kaun Adonis ho? So, who is an Adonis? This you should get it without a doubt. Who is an Adonis, everyone? The love of Venus. Okay, one is definitely C. Correct? Adonis is a handsome man. So one is definitely C. So option B nikal jayega. Option C nikal jayega. Correct. Now guys, one C is common. Two B, ye two, three or four, tino hi alag alag hai A or D mein. Any other one that you know, guys? Don Juan, Wastrel, Lute. Anyone. Anyone that you know. Come on, let's see. Let's see if you can figure this out. This is going to be really interesting. Come on, guys. Thoda sa dimag laga ke khelna. थोड़ा सा दिमाग लगा के खेलना गाइस कम ऑन लेट्स सी हु इज गोना गिव द आंसर डॉन जियोवानी ही इज अ वेरी वेरी फेमस लिबर्टीन गाइस हु इज अ लिबर्टीन हु इज अ लिबर्टीन हमने डिस्कस किया था कैसिनोवा Casanova, libertine. So guys, Casanova, libertine, someone who is a flirt, someone who is a, guys, which option over here is a flirt? Which option over here is a philanderer? Which option here is a corrupt person who takes liberties? Who is a philanderer, guys, here? Haan, Diya. Who is a philanderer here? Correct. Who is a philanderer here, Ravi? Which option means a philanderer? A rake or a seducer? A rake is a corrupt person or a seducer. So answer is 2D. Your answer option will be D for Delhi. So guys, this is a lesson. Skeptical about the existence of God. That is agnostic, Amresh. Wo agnostic hota hai. A rake or a seducer or Don Giovanni Casanova was a big, big flirt. So guys, answer option is 2D. So answer option will be D. Okay, origin of the word, please. So Ravi, it was a fictional character. Theek hai, ye ek fictional character tha, jahan pe there was a character named Don Giovanni. It was in a 17th century ka ek play tha. Us pe based hai ye. Okay, this is a 17th century play. And if you've seen this, guys, this is also, there's also a movie based on this. Have you heard about Johnny Depp? Have you heard of Johnny Depp, guys? I'm sure you've all heard of Donnie Depp. Johnny Depp. Yes or no? You all heard of Johnny Depp? Yes. So guys, Johnny Depp played Don Giovanni in a movie. Okay, so as such, aap is word ka origin jo hai, not related to a particular language. It is related to a play. It is related. Guys, Pirates of the Caribbean. Nobody watched Pirates of the Caribbean. Yes, Diya, what just happened to me was spoonerism. Correct. So guys, it's basically based on a play. It's based on a play, which was a Spanish play. So this is based on a Spanish play, Ravi. Got it? Got it, guys? Yes or no? IFTs rely heavily, guys, heavily on, eponyms. For example, wastrel is a basically a wasteful or a good-for-nothing person. So, jab aap wasteful person bolte ho ya good-for-nothing person bolte ho, loafer. So, that's wastrel. Okay, so this is wastrel. Basically, it means waste, wasteful, loafer. And fourth one will obviously become an awkward or a rough fellow. Fourth one, awkward or rough fellow. Clear, guys, all of you? Yes or no, guys? Any doubts with this? Someone who's very aggressive, someone who's very awkward, someone who is very aggressive man, such a person. Clear? It is of German origin. Ye wala German origin se hai, ye wala Spanish play hai. Clear? Adonis, correct. Correct, Ravi. Adonis is Greek. Okay. Come on. Wastrel kiya tha humne. Is it Diya? Yes. Okay. Kshitij, har jagah ka slang hai wo. Come on, guys. This, you will get it. You have to match the following. N, Marse, Fetter, Melanger, and raspy. You have to match it with the right part of speech. Part of speech is important. Part of speech is important. Come on, which part of speech does it play? Come on, everyone. All of you present here are going to answer this. Come on, guys. 10th question. What is your answer? Come on, guys. Match the following. Okay. Sakshi says D. Himanshi says D. Okay. Ravi says raspy is an adjective for sure. So you're relying on. Okay. So Ravi, guy, Ravi, you've got a very good point. Raspy is an adjective for sure. Raspy is an adjective for sure. When you say a raspy voice is a very hoarse voice. A raspy voice is a very hoarse voice. Matlab thoda sa harsh voice, thoda sa, you know, heavy voice. That kind of a voice is called as a raspy voice. So because of this, I'm sure like you go happy, raspy, etc. You're going with 4 as an adjective. Very good. So I'm going to eliminate option B. I'm going to eliminate option D. Correct. Ab isme difference dhundo, guys. Difference tino hi different hai. Koi bhi ek pakdo. Koi bhi ek pakdo, guys. Come on. You can do it. Tell me the answer. Come on, guys. 4 is A. Come on. What is 3? Melanger kya hai? You're going with C. गाइस साथ में ये ध्यान में रखना, रिमेंबर दिस गाइस दैट एनी वर्ड कैन अ वर्ड कैन प्ले डिफरेंट पार्ट्स ऑफ स्पीच ऑल्सो अ वर्ड कैन प्ले डिफरेंट पार्ट्स ऑफ स्पीच एज वेल सो बी वेरी केयरफुल अबाउट दैट बी वेरी केयरफुल अबाउट दैट Be very careful about that. Nobody? Okay. En masse be noun, ma'am, as mass refers to mass. En masse, okay, is crowd. A. Okay, Malinger look like a verb. Okay. Guys, what is fetter? Haven't you heard of the word fetter? Haven't you heard of the word fetter, guys? Kisi ne nahi suna fetter? Nobody has heard of fetter, guys. The criminal was taken to jail in fetters. क्रिमिनल को आप दिस वॉज द इजिएस्ट वर्ड एन मास आप लोग गलत वर्ड पे फोकस कर रहे हो यस राज यू हैव टू फोकस ऑन द वर्ड फेटर गाइज वॉट इज फेटर द क्रिमिनल वॉज टेकन टू जेल इन फेटर्स फेटर्स का मतलब होता है चेन्स फेटर्स का मतलब होता है जंजीरे सो दैट इज फेटर्स यू वर टेकन इन चेन्स इन कफ्स यू वर टाइड एंड टेकन सो फेटर बेसिकली मीन्स चेन या जंजीर जो आप लोग बोलते हो So what is a zanjeer, guys? What is a chain? A chain has to be a noun. Answer option is A, 2D. Answer option is A. To malign or to malinger is a verb. En masse can be used as an adverb. Everybody gathered en masse. So gather verb hota hai, en masse adverb ho gaya. Did all of you understand this, guys? Come on, the answer option is A. Next one. Underline part ka replacement. This is a grammar question. Come on guys, when you get such questions, pehle to sentence padho pura, then go part by part. Okay, diya, mass is crowd. Mass is crowd, correct? Mass is crowd. But what is, so see, N, I'll break it down. Okay, diya, do you agree N means in? Yes or no? When you say endemic, when you say enter, do you agree that N means in? Yes, okay, I'll explain both of them. Ek minute ruko. Okay, do you agree, diya, that N means in? As a prefix, yes. Do you agree that mass means group? Correct. So this does not mean, this whole reference does not mean group. It means in a group. It means in a group. It means in a crowd. It means in a group. So for example, if I say the cabinet resigned en masse, the class bunked en masse, matlab in group. So, आप define कर रहे हो, this basically means all or everyone, सब के सब. So, when you say the class bunked en masse, bunked, who bunked, how did they bunk, आप bunk को describe कर रहे हो. So, this becomes in a group. So, that is why it is actually an adverb. It is actually an adverb. Clear? Okay, Ravi's question. Guys, what is the meaning of the third option? What do you mean by mal? What do you mean by mal, guys? What do you mean by mal? Mal is what? Good or bad? Mal is what? Good or bad? Bad? Okay, how many of you, I'll ask you this question, guys. How many of you have feigned an illness? How many of you have feigned an illness to get out of work? Kis kis ne jhoot bol ke class ya work ya school ya college miss kiya hai? How many of you have feigned an illness, guys? Anybody has feigned means pretend. Any of you have ever, obviously, guys, all of us must have feigned an illness some point of time in our life, right? सबके सबने किया होगा एट सम पॉइंट इन आर लाइफ सो दैट इज मेलिंजर टू मेलिंजर बेसिकली मीन्स टू प्रिटेंड टू बी सिक और इल टू फेन एन इलनेस टू गेट आउट ऑफ वर्क और टू गेट आउट ऑफ ऑफिस गॉट इट एवरीवन यस ओके सो आई हैव अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल हु हैव मेलिंजर्ड या हु हैव फेन्ड एन इलनेस ओके कम ऑन गाइस 11th क्वेश्चन सो यू हैव टू सिलेक्ट द पार्ट रिप्लेसमेंट Sky Airlines recently announced aggressive cost-cutting measures ranging from a new airport check-in procedures that encourage passengers to use self-service kiosks and reductions in the size of its fleet. Of course, Himanshi, sabke sabne kiya hai. Maine kafi baar kiya hai, Himanshi. Of course, Rugved. Amresh, the monthly ones. Amresh is a very, kya bolte, history sheeter ho, Amresh, aap to. मेलिंजरिंग के मामले में ओके कम ऑन गाइस 11th क्वेश्चन कम ऑन एवरीवन 11th one. Correct, Vaibhav. Arey, yes, Diya. Come on, guys. Go part by part, guys. Dekho which option. There could be multiple errors, but most importantly, guys, focus on subject verb agreement. Focus on conjunctions. Come on, everyone. 11th question. What is your answer? Airport check procedure, airport check-in procedure. So, ek-ek-ek point le-lekar, ek-ek-ek-ek. Ravi, dekho. Take one, take the differences between the options. Just one, check procedure kaise ho sakta hai? Okay, guys, is it check procedure or check-in procedures? You check in airport or you check in? Jab aap check-in karte ho for your flight, do you check or you check in? It has to be check-in. So, I will eliminate option A. I'm going to eliminate option A. A is going to be my first elimination. Now, ab dekho guys, baki ke similar hai na. So, see the differences, Ravi. Come on. Everybody for that matter, guys, see the differences. Options mein differences dekho. Okay, 1 second, guys. This is not working. 1 minute, guys. We'll just connect. Okay. So, I'm going to eliminate A. Sabse pehle, correct? A nikal dete hain. Now, look at the difference, guys. Ranging from new airport check-in procedures, that encourage passengers, Yahan tak same hai. To use self-service. Kiosks. Ye part alag hai. Correct. Now, guys, don't you find the link from aaya hai? Ranging from. When I say ranging from, uske baad kya aana chahiye? Sakshi, kiosks. You have those self-check-in kiosks or hubs. Jab aap wo hub bolte ho, like those are called kiosks. Like kiosks are small. Kya bolte ho aap usse? What do I say? It's like a small operation point, a small cubicle jaise banawa hota hai, a small booth. So kiosk is like a booth. Okay, so ranging from ke baad kya aayega? To. After ranging from, you have to put to, correct? So ranging from and to kyu aayega? Only to is enough. Off will not come. So your answer option is what? C. Your answer option is C. Pairing dekho guys. Both and. Not only but also. Either or. Neither nor. From to. So answer option will be C. Come on, next one. 12th question, everyone. Try the 12th one out. 12th question, guys. Come on, everyone. 12th question. Although the square root of a negative number has no real value, it is not necessarily true. Dekho, part by part jao. Equations involving these imaginary numbers, kahan pe place karoge aap? Inapplicable kahan pe place karoge? So compare the differences between the options. Come on. 12th question. Come on, guys. Come on, guys. Let's see who gives the right answer. Eliminate. Go by the elimination method. D. Jaswan, it should be inapplicable practically or practically inapplicable. Do you say it's possible practically, guys? Or you say it's it's impossible practically or it's practically impossible? Kya bologe aap? Do you say it's impossible practically or it's practically impossible? What do you say? You say it's practically impossible. You will say it's practically inapplicable. So D option goes out. Okay, D option chala jayega. Look at A. Equations involving these inapplicable imaginary numbers are practical. How can equations be practical? You're saying that these are imaginary numbers. These are inapplicable numbers. How can the equations be practical? You cannot change the meaning. Aap meaning nahi change kar sakte ho. Meaning question bol raha hai ki they are inapplicable. You are changing the meaning in option A. So option A bhi nikal jayega. Equations involving such imaginary numbers have no practical applications. Correct. There is no practical applications for equations involving such imaginary numbers as these. Why do you need to say as these here? Why do you need to put as these here? Correct. Such imaginary numbers is enough. Such imaginary numbers is enough. You don't need to put as these. Correct. So what is your answer option going to be? Your answer option is going to be B. Did all of you understand this? Yes or no? B is correct. Yes. Okay. Come on, guys. Next one. Nature of the phrase or clause. IFT question hai ye bhi. He failed in spite of his best efforts. This is an adjective. It is an adverb. It is a noun. What is it? Is it a phrase or a clause? Pehle toh aap ye batao, guys, ki phrase or clause mein difference kya hai? We have discussed this. What is the difference between phrase and clause? Phrase and clause, what was the simplest way? Guys, there are going to be many definitions out there which are going to confuse you. But I have told you the simplest way to differentiate between a phrase and a clause. What is that difference? Let's see who remembers it. The simplest difference. A phrase has no verb in it. A clause has a verb in it. Correct? Phrase does not have a verb in it. A clause has a verb in it. Verb. Phrase has a verb in it. Sorry. Phrase does not have a verb in it. A clause has a verb in it. Correct. Now see this. In spite of his best efforts. In spite of his best efforts, there is no verb here. So it cannot be a clause. It is going to be a phrase. Ye phrase hi hoga. Yes, Kshitij. Kshitij, if you know the rule and aap log dheere dheere step by step karoge ye questions, aapko aasani. Which one, Kshitij? The 13th one or the 12th one? The 13th one or the 12th one? Which one, Kshitij? So it is definitely going to be a phrase. It is definitely going to be a phrase. Now, you have to check. He failed in spite of his best efforts. Guys, bas aapko ye check karna hai ki what is this describing? 13th wala. No, Kshitij, listen to this. This is the easiest way. Agar noun, phrase ya clause hota, it is going to answer to the question who, what or where. Okay, if it is going to be an adverbial phrase or clause, it is going to add to a verb. If it is going to be an adjective ka phrase or clause, it is going to add to a noun. It is going to describe or add to a noun. If it is going to be a prepositional phrase, it is going to start with a preposition. So preposition se start hoga. Jaise aap to se start karo, in se start karo, on se start karo, preposition se start hoga. So, Ravi says failed is a verb. So, if failed is a verb, ye kya ho gaya? What did this become? Efforts, ye sab kya hai? You're saying he failed. Failed is a verb. So, this describes failure. So, answer option will be B. Because what is it modifying? Humko dekhna hai ki wo kya modify kar raha hai. So, failed verb hai, to ye adverb ban jayega. Did all of you understand this? Yes or no? Did all of you understand this? Come on. Next one. Play with the options also, guys. Let's see more. How to find the way to the ruins is the question. Is the question. Dimag laga ke bolna, guys. How to find the way to the ruins is the question. How to find. Who ka answer nahi de ra? He failed who? He failed who? Matlab? Ye failed who nahi hai? Who ka answer kaise de ra hai ye? Ravi, clause basically has a verb in it. So, isme in spite of is a in spite of conjunction, preposition, pronoun, adjective, noun. So, yahan pe koi bhi verb nahi hai. Yahan pe koi bhi verb nahi tha. Did all of you understand this? Come on, next one. Next one. How to find the way to the ruins? How to find the way to the ruins is the question. Ask yourself, what is the question? Anything which answers to the question what? Who failed? Na, but Azad, you don't have to say इस पार्ट का नेचर नहीं बताना है हमको, हमको अंडरलाइन पार्ट का नेचर बताना है. सो अंडरलाइन पार्ट इज नॉट अ नाउन, ही इज अ नाउन, फेल्ड इज अ वर्ब. अंडरलाइन पार्ट का नेचर बताना है. सो व्हाट अंडरलाइन का देखना है, करेक्ट, अंडरलाइन का देखना है. व्हाट इज द क्वेश्चन, सो व्हाट इज योर आंसर, नाउन. वेरी गुड. व्हाट इज द क्वेश्चन, इफ इट आंसर्स टू द क्वेश्चन हु, व्हाट और वेयर, वो नाउन हो जाएगा. सो आंसर विल बिकम नाउन. क्लियर? कम ऑन, नेक्स्ट वन. सिंस यू हैव ऑलरेडी डिसाइडेड, why do you ask my opinion? Since, focus on since guys, focus on since. Since kya hai? If you know the part of speech of since, aapko ye mil jayega. Humne discuss kiya tha, since kya hai guys? Have verb hai, have verb hai, to phrase to ho nahi sakta, to ye directly clause hoga. Answer option will be D, since is an adverb. Nahi diya, since yahan pe adverb hai. And it's a clause. No, have is a verb. So it cannot be a phrase. It has to be a clause. There is only one option which gives you the word clause in it. So what will your answer be? Your answer option will be D. Since is an adverb. Since is an adverb because here diya, since is not indicating time, vagera, vagera. Here since is similar to because. Jaise aap bolte na, because you have already decided. Matlab waise, as, because, etc. Theek hai Ravi. I'll explain phrase or clause ka difference ek bar for you. Listen to this. So answer option over here is clause. Okay, Ravi, I'm going to give you the classic example which I always give. So aapko isse acche se yaad ho jayega. Listen to this. If I say Ravi, okay, Ravi, you like dogs or cats? You're a cat person or a dog person, Ravi? You're a cat person or a dog person? Ravi, cats or dogs? Quickly. Dog. Okay. So if Ravi says the dog with the blue collar, the dog with the blue collar is mine. The dog with the blue collar is mine. Okay. The dog which has a blue collar, let's say round its neck, is mine. Okay. Now, Ravi, we have to decide, ye jo underlined part hai, is it a phrase or a clause? It is a phrase or a clause. Now, when I say the dog with the blue collar, Ravi, is pure part mein, do you see any verb? Is pure part mein, Ravi, do you see any verb? With this preposition, the is article, blue is adjective, collar is noun. There is no verb. Yahan pe koi verb nahi hai. So, ये क्या हो गया, ये फ्रेज हो गया, ये फ्रेज हो गया. यहाँ पे राउंड वर्ब नहीं है, राउंड प्रेपोजिशन है. हैज वर्ब है, हैज इज द वर्ब, हैज हैड हैविंग, ऑल ऑफ दीज आर वर्ब्स. सो इसीलिए ये पार्ट क्लॉज हो गया, दिस बिकम्स अ क्लॉज. डिड ऑल ऑफ यू अंडरस्टैंड दिस? यस और नो? डिड ऑल ऑफ यू अंडरस्टैंड दिस? सो हियर, सिंस यू हैव ऑलरेडी डिसाइडेड, ये क्लॉज हो गया. So answer option will be D. Clear? Come on, next one. The poor debtor intended to pay back every penny of the money. He intended to pay back every penny of the money. Come on, let's see who gets the right answer. The poor debtor intended to pay back every penny of the money. Come on, guys, what is your answer? Okay, so what is your answer? What is your answer? Come on, guys, let's see who gets the right answer. Let's see who gets the answer, guys. Okay, who will get the answer? D, B. Okay, you're saying D. Most of you are going with an adverb clause. Okay, why? Because intended is a verb. Correct. Very good. Very good, guys. Correct answer. Okay, did all of you understand this now? Yes or no? Did all of you understand this now? Clear? Okay. Come on, guys. Let's go to different types of questions. 1 minute. Guys, can we try this out? Are you all up for this? IFT की स्पेशलिटी है गाइस ये. आर यू ऑल अप फॉर दिस? क्रॉसवर्ड. ओके, दिस क्वेश्चन लुक्स रियली इंटिमिडेटिंग, पर ये है एक्चुअली थोड़ा सा इजी. करेक्ट दिया. ये जसवंत IFT का क्वेश्चन है. लेट्स डू इट. ओके, लिसन टू दिस गाइस. यू हैव वर्ड्स व्हिच हैव बीन गिवन इन द टेबल बिलो. ठीक है, कंप्लीट द क्रॉसवर्ड यूजिंग द वर्ड्स फ्रॉम द अबाउट टेबल. देर आर मोर वर्ड्स देन रिक्वायर्ड. नाउ दिस इज द हिंट. आई डोंट नो इफ एनी ऑफ यू हैव प्लेड क्रॉसवर्ड. आज से क्रॉसवर्ड फिल करना शुरू. ओके, लिसन टू दिस गाइस. नाउ फर्स्ट वन, अक्रॉस. ये फर्स्ट है. अक्रॉस मीन्स वॉट गाइस? सी, कैन आई से, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू हैव सीन क्रॉसवर्ड? इसमें आपको थोड़ा सा क्रॉसवर्ड कैसे वर्क होता है वो भी पता होना चाहिए. नाउ गाइज, वन अक्रॉस एंड वन डाउन. कैन आई से दिस इज वन डाउन एंड दिस इज वन अक्रॉस? यस और नो? वन अक्रॉस होगा ये हॉरिजॉन्टल वाला और वन डाउन होगा ये वर्टिकल वाला. यस और नो? हेलो चिराग. वन अक्रॉस इज द हॉरिजॉन्टल वाला एंड वन डाउन इज द वर्टिकल वाला. यस और नो? यस. ओके, सो नाउ गाइस, वन अक्रॉस में यू नीड अ वर्ड विच मीन्स नेटिव टू और कन्फाइंड टू अ सर्टेन रीजन. कैन यू टेल मी विच ऑप्शन मीन्स, विच ऑफ दीज वर्ड्स मीन्स? यू नो दिस वर्ड, एवरीबडी नोज दिस वर्ड. राइट नाउ वॉट वी आर फेसिंग इज अ पैंडेमिक. करेक्ट, बट इट इज स्प्रेड एवरीवेयर. बट इफ इट वॉज नेटिव टू और कन्फाइंड ओनली टू अ सर्टेन रीजन, वॉट वुड बी योर आंसर गाइज? वॉट वुड दैट बी कॉल्ड? दैट वुड बी कॉल्ड एज एन एंडेमिक. हाँ या ना? दैट वुड बी कॉल्ड एज एन एंडेमिक. सो फर्स्ट में वी नीड द वर्ड एंडेमिक. ई एन डी ई एम आई सी. ओके, यहाँ पे हम लगा देंगे एंडेमिक. ई एन डी ई एम आई सी. ओके, सो वन वन में क्या घुसेगा गाइस? 15. सो विच ऑप्शन गिव्स यू 115? विच ऑप्शन गिव्स यू 115? डन. क्वेश्चन आंसर्ड गाइस. आंसर आ गया, मार्क मिल गया. सो यू डू नॉट, डोंट बी इंटिमिडेटेड गाइस. एग्जैक्टली रवि, ऑप्शन यूज किया और आ गया. एंडेमिक मीन्स 115. डन. आंसर ऑप्शन इज सी. जस्ट प्ले बाय योर ऑप्शन गाइज. सिर्फ हमको ऑप्शन देखना है. ओके, डिड ऑल ऑफ यू अंडरस्टैंड दिस गाइज? यू डोंट इवन हैव टू वरी अबाउट एनीथिंग एल्स. यू जस्ट हैव टू वरी अबाउट द ऑप्शन. क्लियर? करेक्ट. सो गाइज, ऐसे ही हमने कल जैट में देखा था. वेन यू गेट अ वेरी बिग डिसीजन मेकिंग केस स्टडी, यू नो पीपल, मतलब आप लोग किसी और एंगल में चले जाएंगे एंड ऑल ऑफ दैट. ओके, सो गाइज, वेन यू गेट सच क्वेश्चन, बी अ लिटिल रिलैक्स्ड. ध्यान से करो, यू विल गेट योर आंसर. Now let us see down, guys. Balance of forces or interest. Okay, I do not know how many of you know this, but look at this. Equipoise. Can I say equi means balance, guys? Can I say equi means balance? Yes or no? So can I say one down will be equipoise? Wo bhi fit ho gaya because equi means balance. So this is also correct. Look at the second one. Inclined to lay down, inclined to lay down principles as undeniably true. मतलब जो अपने principles दूसरों पे थोपता है, like a doctrinaire or like a dogmatic person, like a doctrinaire or like a dogmatic person. Done. Dogmatic. We have done principles. All of you should get this. So can I say 2 and 6 are also correct? We have done the root word doctrine. मतलब हमने doctrine dogmatic किया है. Okay. Look at the third one. Attempting to avoid confrontation or anger, someone who is very calm, मतलब उसको confrontation नहीं पसंद है. Someone who is very calm, emollient, emollient. Guys, mall. What is mall as a root word? Come on, everyone. What do you mean by the root word mall? Exactly, Ravi. Dogmatic तो कितने बार किया है? No, same Imanshi. Both are similar. Okay, well, doctrine and doctrinaire. Doctrine is principle, it is the noun. Doctrinaire is a person who enforces his principles on others, like a dictator. Mol means soft, guys. Mol means soft. For example, mollusks. Mollusks are animals which have a very soft body. If I say your parents mollycoddle you means treat you very softly. So emollient is basically something which is very soft or soothing or calm. So 3 का 3 बैठ गया. Okay, now look at 4. A speech or a piece of writing that praises someone or something highly. Praise, guys. Praising someone or something highly. Which option? Which option? Come on, 17th वाला देखो एवरीवन. 17th वाला देखो. The answer is encomium. Clear? So your answer option is C. It is just a case of match the following. Correct. Oh, very good, Rugved. So guys, don't be intimidated by these questions. Okay? हम लोग इसको इजिली सॉल्व कर सकते हैं. वी विल कंटिन्यू विद दीज क्वेश्चंस इन द कमिंग अप क्लासेस एज वेल गाइस. वी विल डू अ लॉट ऑफ दिस. सो गाइस, द आंसर की इज पिंड अप. डू ट्राई आउट दीज क्वेश्चंस. व्हाट हैपेंस नाउ गाइस? बाकी वर्ड्स के मीनिंग, यस रवि, आई वांट यू टू गो थ्रू इट एंड देन वी विल डिस्कस इट. नाउ गाइस, आई वांट ऑल ऑफ यू टू जॉइन द स्पेशल क्लास व्हिच स्टार्ट्स एट 6 PM. सो गाइस, स्पेशल क्लास 6 PM. वी विल कंटिन्यू विद दीज टाइप्स ऑफ क्वेश्चंस, वोकैबुलरी एंड ग्रामर की इन डेप्थ प्रैक्टिस करेंगे फॉर स्नैप, एनमैट, आईएफटी, जैट एंड फॉर ऑल ऑफ दीज एग्जामिनेशंस. आई क्विकली वांट यू टू गो टू द अनअकैडमी लर्निंग ऐप एंड जॉइन द सेशन गाइस. द लिंक हैज बीन पोस्टेड ऑन द ग्रुप. लेट्स क्रैक इट एवरीवन. आई वांट ऑल ऑफ यू टू टेक द प्लस सब्सक्रिप्शन गाइस. मत भूलना. करेक्ट दिया, मॉली कॉडल. सो गाइस, डू नॉट फॉरगेट टू टेक द प्लस सब्सक्रिप्शन एंड अनलॉक द स्पेशल क्लास एंड अनलॉक द फ्री प्लान यूजिंग द कोड रितु एमबीए. Press the like button, share button, subscribe button, and Ritu MBA all the way, guys. Okay? Like, share, subscribe. Thank you, everyone, and see you all today in the special classes. Chalo. See you, everyone. Ha, correct. Correct, Diya. So it's all about, you know, it's more like a test of your nerves also, whether you're able to navigate through it easily or not. Okay, waiting, guys. Even I'll meet you on the Unacademy learning app now. Take care, everyone.